And hey YouTube, it's Thomas again, and Little Wizard Thomas, TitanSlinger here. We're just picking up on the last video, which was building platforms. Ooh, blackout again. Building platforms up to, well, I've only taken it up three levels just as a demo in the last video. What we're going to look at now is how to sink the platforms back down again. So we want to start heading down towards the water level down here. So straight into it again, I'm just going to throw down a scaffolding on the ground. Ooh. Now, you'll find that little invisible barrier. Whoa! I'm doing weird things to my computer, excuse me, sorry. You'll find that the barrier that runs along the cliff that stops you running off the edge that we've just had to build up to come out over the top of actually stops you from placing, from where I am on this side, I can't put anything out over the edge. That is a bit of a problem, so we have to run to this side and then back through this side. And we'll do that for a little bit. A bit of a pain in the backside, but that's the price you pay when you're glitching and having fun and doing trickery. So I'm going to put a small blue trim rug on top of the scaffold there and select it. And now I'm just going to pop it off the end of the platform at the end there, and see, it's now sunk down low. The thing is, we can't get it as high. We actually have to work twice as hard to build down as we would otherwise building upwards, because you can see from the bottom of that scaffold to that first step is about twice the distance of what we're about to build down by putting a platform down on this rung here. So it takes quite a while. And I'm just going to do the first few to show you. So we'll continue on here. Small blue trim rug and tatami end to end. I select the blue trim rug, stick it under the end of me. Oh, and I'll do it again. Sorry, in the last video I keep on not putting this in the right spot, and I do it every time. I'm like a fish forgetting plants in the aquarium. 2 second memory. Anyway, go, flip that around, and stick that on there. Perfect. Now, how do we get that scaffold out? Well, I've shown you a few times now how to move platforms, rugs, and things out of the way using a mat. So that's exactly what we're going to do. I'll pop a mat on the corner of the platform. I'm going to rotate it around like that. Now, if I select the small blue trim rug on top, you recall if I select the scaffold and move it, everything moves. We don't want that, so I right mouse click and it drops back. I select the blue trim rug on top of the scaffold and I move that, and that moves, but I don't actually need to pick it up. I can pop it back onto that platform there and position it ready to go down. I can then move this platform back down to the ground. Oh. There we go. I'll snaffle that rug there, the small blue trim rug on the end of the platform, and use that to pick up this one. We'll just reuse, recycle, you know, rather than putting stuff down again and again. Okay, same again. Tatami mat, we're going to slide that platform out the way. We're going to select the blue trim rug and move that scaffolding there. Move the blue trim rug. Perfect. Over to there. Platform around. So you could just die of boredom and repetition doing this. It's going to take like 30 platforms to get down to water level. But I can tell you it's been done because I've done it. Okay. Now, something else what I tend to do when I'm building is teleporter points. So you can put teleporter points up onto a platform here like this. It's not going to let me put one out there because of that boundary that I was talking about, this line that's running down along the cliff. So I'm going to right click and ignore that, or cancel that teleporter placement. And I'm just going to, come on, there we go. I'm just going to flip this around, and now I run on this side of the border, and hey presto, I can pop down a teleporter point. And then I'm going to pop that teleporter back on the ground over there. That's the only one I've got at the moment. So once I port out here, I can't get back, which is always interesting. But when I hit a point of not being able to manipulate and move things around anymore, when I can't sort of reach out, when we're working all the way down here, I then teleport. I have two teleporters. I set one up to and one up from. And now I'm out at my my platform out here. Again, it's going to be a problem getting back, isn't it? Bit stupid of me. But anyway, so I'll leave it at that, because I'll just ramble on for hours and hours. But this is how you've seen how to build the platforms up and move them, sort of get up over that lip on the edge of the cliff, and then using your scaffolding and your platforms just to manipulate, move things around, get your tatami rug, and just roll platforms out of the way like that, so that you can pick up your scaffolding. Now, just one final thing on that, because I might as well cover it in this video since we're talking about it, is how to put down those tricky little glitches with like stepping stones up in the sky. So if I were to, I haven't got any stepping stones, but I'm going to put down a long blue runner, because I have one of those, and it won't let me put it on the ground over there. Alright, hang on, we're going to pause this, port out and come back in, just one moment. Okay, and I've just ported back into the house, and I actually detoured while I was there and got some stepping stones from Mushu, so we're just going to roll back down here and see. You'll actually see things have reset themselves. I was saying before, when you move platforms out of the way and port out of the house and back in, things reset to the original point that you put them in. So I'd rolled these out of the way, I'd rolled that out of the way, and everything's come back into its position. I'm just going to show you how to pop down some stepping stones now that we've got all of this set up. Oh, all of my mats, all of my mats. I don't have any small blue trim mats, so I'm going to use two tatamis. I don't like using two tatamis, but here we go. To lift this so it's sticking out over that point. This, by the way, you'll see now that I've taken the mat away, in some of my houses I've got a teleporter glitch where you go into a teleporter and you end up in the sky. All I've done is built up with my platforms like this, put a teleporter point, and then I take the platform away. So when you port in, this is where you port to, and then when you move, you drop back down out of it. So it's pretty easy to do that. I know people really like the old teleporter glitches. It's very, very simple to do. So let me just grab my, I'm not in housing menu, we'll grab that mat, and I'm going to place that down on this wooden platform here. Okay, now the problem is I've got these mats here, so I want to remove them again. So what I do is I just rotate this out of the way. If I don't quite get it out of the way, I have another go. There we go, I'm going to move it right up there. Now I can move those mats out of the way and pop them back down there, and I can put this platform back here. And not only that, I can actually roll it a bit further forward, so I've got a good space to pop the next stepping stones onto. Here we go. Grab my next one. Select the tatami mat, just slipped in under it. I'll pop over here. And now you have to sit it overlapping, because if I just sit it like this, there's a gap in between the two, and when you try and run along them, when you take it everything down and you go to run along it, you can't jump or move from one to the other. So you have to sit the stones overlapping a little bit like this. You can even put curves in it by overlapping them on a corner. I can flip it back the other way and go back here, except I can't put the rug down. So I'm just going to sit this one like that. Now I place down a tatami mat and I rotate the platform out the way, and I can pick up the rug. I actually think I'm a, I I've just gone on to the scaffolding here, so I'm probably going to pick up the scaffolding when I do this. And let's do that anyway. Oh, no, I only picked up the rugs. Wow. There you go. So, essentially, rotate using a mat to rotate the platform into whatever position you need it. And this is where you just need one platform out there to build an entire walkway. You don't have to do a whole runway of platforms and then stuff around with it or leave mats down. You can just put one mat down and keep on rotating your platform around and building along if you've got a vantage point to look down on it. So there you go, little tips and tricks, building down over the edge and how to chuck some stepping stones down to create a little air path. Like that. Brilliant. Okay. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you liked, please subscribe. Got some more videos coming on sinking objects and a couple of other little tricks. So thanks for watching and I'll see you again. Bye.